tell us a little something about your sibling?
My brother's name is Vincent.
My siblings' names are Connor and Hannah.
I lost my twin brother, Tom, when we were 17.
My brother, Gabriel, passed away when he was 7 of cancer.
My brother's name was Liam.
My sister is Caroline.
And we loved dancing, playing around in the house, making Legos, traveling the world together with our mom.
She was always on her toes, always kept us on our toes. There was music everywhere. She loved music. She also loved technology. She loved her iPad, and if you took that away from her, she would claw you.
I was completely unprepared to lose anyone, especially someone so young.
For me, the worst was waiting in a separate room at the hospital while they operated on my brother. Every second that goes by, you know it's less likely that he'll come out of the operating room.
For me, it's probably my most vivid memory. Like, every time I'm thinking about it, it's like I'm reliving it almost.
Thanks to my mom, she didn't want me to see my brother pass away. So on the day, she got some friends to invite me to some place to go play. And when I came back, my brother was already in heaven.
I don't really remember any of it other than that morning. I more remember feelings afterwards.
It's hard for a younger person to openly discuss on how they feel with their sibling's death.
It was weird being at home and there was nobody there. It was very strange.
The school felt emptier than when it had when my brother was there.
My mom is the one who often like talks about Kara and like shares all of her like funny moments and stuff, and it's very sentimental.
I remember one picture where he and my sister were both holding me up when I was 1 year old. I have no idea where that was.
Every time I look at them, it makes like me and my parents laugh.
Show us.
So cute.
I would also remember the way he loved sticking his hand in either a freshly iced or cake batter so he could take the cake home while at Roger's house.
You can't go against the flow of the river, so you might as well accept it. And so it took me a lot of time to accept it. And to this day, it's still hard, but it's my force to keep going and to get back up.
I find when someone first passes away, you focus a lot on the grief and the pain of not having them. But as time goes by, you either try to use it as a positive inspiration or, you know, a fuel to help other people.
Even though it's really sad, you should try and celebrate the life they had and the memories you have with them instead of being sad about the time you didn't have with them. So you should just try and hold on to those memories for as long as possible.